first trip with Geocamp, we went to Waipatiki Beach and it was pouring down with rain, and we saw erosion on action on the way because there were slips, lots of slips. And when we actually got to the beach, the sand was going away, part of the beach was being washed away by all the rain. Then we went to a rock outcrop where there were lots of rocks, so people were hammering away at the rocks trying to get samples, and some people found a few fossils of scallops and sea urchins. And weather doesn't stop science or scientists, so we had to get wet and it was really cold. This is a photo of me, soaking wet and really cold, but it was good fun.
There was like lots of different layers in the cliff. One of them was really dark grey mud from really deep down under the water and in the sea. There was some fossils of sea creatures, and there was a couple of shells in there too. And then when we moved further up, there was sand from a beach with lots of fossils in it. And then we went a little bit further up and there was lots and lots of shells. And when we went further up, there was a big cliff that had river stones in it and mud in it, which indicates that the sea level had gone down over the years and made a river.
One of the places we visited was Lake Tutira, and a long time ago that used to be a river that flowed out to the sea, and it was big cliffs on either side. Then a large landslide fell down the cliffs and blocked off the river. And then the water level rose, and that created Lake Tutira. First of all, we looked at the whole landscape, and we were told that we had to draw it. So we did a very simple representation of the mountains. And then we went down to the lake, and Kyle and Richard took a big pipe and they hammered it into the lake floor. And then they pulled it out and they laid that on the ground. And once they laid it down, they stuck a big stick in one end and they hammered the whole core out of the pipe. And then we could see all the different layers and all sorts of things. And you could see when volcanic eruptions had occurred, and bits of pumice and leaves. And you could see all the things that happened in the past.
On one of our days, we went to Mangahouanga, and we went to where Jones' hut was. So we explored the huts for a while. So after we looked at those, we went down to the stream and saw if we could find any fossils. We found a few things, some shark's teeth and heaps of shells and some reptile dung. And in the reptile dung, there were you could see fish scales and a few fish bones. And then we went through the bush for quite a long walk into another part of the stream, and we took a look there, and there was a plesiosaur bone. It's just very interesting. The bones that we have found were in big boulders. The boulders were just huge around the bones.
On our last trip, we went to Cape Kidnappers, which is a long line of cliffs, and the cliffs are really tall, and you can see all the layers and all the rocks and everything in there. So we saw sandstone, ash layers, gravel, shells, and in some of these layers we could see fossils, and some of the fossils were broken from where the water current had gone past them, and others were all together and still intact where the water had obviously been not as rough. We also found a whale bone in a big boulder, and on one side we got part of the whale bone, and then on the other side we found more of the bone, so it went right through the rock. We also saw heaps of fault lines, and they stood out because the rocks, all the layers didn't match up. Sometimes they've been pushed down or up. So these white layers are from massive volcanic eruptions in the central North Island. I think Cape Kidnappers is a great place to go and find rocks because the cliffs are so high and there's heaps of different layers and heaps of fault lines and fossils. Heaps of fossils.